Welcome back to Building Character, where we figure out how to play as your favorite fictional characters in Dungeons & Dragons. Remember to like and subscribe for better initiative next time you play. Maybe. Today we're building everyone's favorite frog-themed DJ, Lucio from Overwatch. While Lucio is my favorite character from the game, the main reason we're building him is a distinct lack of bards. Over 20 videos and no chaotic neutral music mages? Unacceptable. Let's start off with our goals for this build. First, we need to heal, as Lucio is primarily a support hero. Next, we gotta go fast, rolling around at the speed of sound and really driving our enemies up a wall. Finally, we'll get some sound-based spells to boop our enemies into oblivion. For stats, we're using the standard point array from the player's handbook. Roll if you want, I'm just not there to check your numbers. Charisma will be our number one. A DJ has to know how to keep a crowd on their feet. Dexterity after that, rollerblades give you a distinct advantage to avoiding attacks. Intelligence next, he modifies his weapons to make them more trumpety. Constitution after that, we're gonna need a few concentration spells for this build, so let's get that. Wisdom will be on the lower end. Professional musicians tend to damage their ears, hurting their perception. Finally, we're gonna dump strength. I only want it for climbing speed, but there's something in the build that will solve that issue much better. Lucio is a variant human, the variant being his rollerblades. We'll reflect that with the mobile feat, increasing our movement speed by 10, and letting us ignore difficult terrain while dashing. You also don't provoke opportunity attacks from creatures you hit with melee attacks, but we're not gonna be using a lot of those, so don't worry about it. Add 1 to your charisma and dexterity, take a free language of your choice, and athletics for your skill. The entertainer background will give you acrobatics and performance proficiency, but we'll swap in rustic hospitality from the folk hero background. Lucio is beloved by the common people. They'll find a room for him without a performance, though I'm sure he'd do one anyway. We'll start off as a bard, which gives us proficiency in any 3 skills we want. Take stealth, medicine, and persuasion. Bards have bardic inspiration, which means that you can give an ally a d6 stat to ability checks, attack rolls, or saving throws in the next 10 minutes as a bonus action. They have to be able to hear you and be within 60 feet of you. You can do this amount of times equal to your charisma modifier per long rest. You get 2 cantrips. Minor illusion can create some small visual illusion, but it can also create sound. So turn up the volume and give yourself some harmony while you play one of the 4 musical instruments you're proficient with. Thunderclap forces a constitution save on creatures within 5 feet of you. Failing it, they take 1d6 thunder damage. You also know 4 first level spells at this level. Check out Heroism, which gives a creature of your choice immunity to being frightened and gives them temporary hit points equal to your charisma modifier at start of each of their turns for up to a minute if you maintain your concentration. Healing Word heals 1d4 plus your charisma modifier as a bonus action. Long Strider increases a creature's movement speed by 10 feet for an hour, and Cure Wounds heals 1d8 plus your charisma modifier as an action. Second level bards get Song of Rest, which adds 1d6 to healing done on short rests for yourself and any creatures you deem friendly. Additionally, you get Jack of All Trades, letting you add half your proficiency bonus to any skill you're not proficient with. You learn another spell. Thunder Wave will boop enemies that fail a constitution save, dealing 2d8 thunder damage and pushing them back 10 feet. If they pass the save, they take half damage and aren't pushed. I'm looking at you, Orisa. Third level bards can get expertise in 2 skills. Acrobatics and performance really are Lucio's bread and butter, so double that proficiency bonus. You can also choose a bard college and we'll grab the College of Satire. It's an unearthed arcana online, so look it up for free, hooray. You get proficiency with thieves' tools, sleight of hand, and a skill of your choice, and go for investigation. Use these to break into the Vishkar Corporation. You're also a tumbling fool, which means that as a bonus action you can dash or disengage, and you have a climbing speed equal to your normal movement, and take half damage from falling. Finally, you have second level spells now. Shatter deals 3d8 thunder damage to creatures in a 10-foot radius that fail a con save. They have disadvantage if they're made of inorganic material, so it's great for taking out those evil omnics. Fourth level bards get an ability score improvement or a feat. Grab the crossbow expert feat, letting you ignore the reloading elements of a hand crossbow. Oh, that's what you should be using, by the way. And you can make an attack within 5 feet without disadvantage. You also grab another spell. The spell Blindness Deafness will work. We're gonna focus on the deafness aspect. The enemy makes a con save or is deafened, meaning they automatically fail anything that has to do with hearing. Fifth level bards get to use d8s for their inspiration, and you recover that inspiration on a short rest instead of just a long rest. You can also learn third level spells, but we're gonna go with Enhance Ability from the second level. This gives a creature of your choice advantage on skill checks of one type. Best options are Constitution. It also gives them 2d6 extra hit points. Strength, because it also doubles their carrying capacity, or Dexterity, as it removes fall damage from heights of 20 or less. This is a pretty flexible spell. Cast it where you need to. This also lasts for an hour if you're maintaining your concentration. Sixth level bards get Counter Charm, which gives creatures within 30 feet of you advantage on saves against being charmed or frightened. It's a nice little spell that isn't really a spell, but it takes an action to use. There's also Fool's Insight from College of Satire, letting you cast Detect Thoughts a number of times equal to your charisma modifier. This lets you read surface level thoughts and probe deeper if the target lets you on a failed wisdom save. There's flavor here that says passing the save still makes them make an embarrassing social gaffe up to your DM. This isn't totally in character, but until we have a short, we don't know that Lucio can't read minds. For your spell, Lesser Restoration lets you remove an effect of blindness, deafness, paralyzation, or poisoning. 7th level bards can learn 4th level spells. Freedom of movement makes one target immune to being slowed down, whether that's from difficult terrain, spells, or paralyzation. They can also break out of manacles with 5 feet of movement, as long as they're not magical manacles. 8th level bards get an ability score improvement and will bump up our charisma for better spells and harder saves. 9th level bards learn 5th level spells. Mass Cure Wounds heals up to 6 creatures in a 30-foot radius, 3d8, plus your charisma modifier. Song of Rest is also a d8 instead of a d6, but that's fine. 10th level bard is one of the best level ups in the game. Your inspiration die are now d10s. You get expertise in 2 more skills. I'd go for stealth and medicine. Best of all, magical secrets lets you take 2 spells from any list. Haste doubles the target's movement speed, increases their AC by 2, and gives them advantage on dex saves and an extra action once per round. This lasts for up to a minute, depending on concentration, and when it ends, the target has to wait around before acting or reacting. Poor Soldier 76 is getting a little too old to go that fast. Beacon of Hope lasts for up to a minute, and gives creatures in a 30-foot radius an advantage on wisdom saves, death saves, and automatically heals them the maximum amount instead of rolling for it. This is also concentration, so choose between speed or healing, just like in the game. 11th level bards can learn 6th level spells, and the Irresistible Dance is the bardiest of bard spells. He forces a wisdom save on a creature, failing that, they have to dance. They use their whole movement to dance, they have disadvantage on dexterity saves and attack rolls, and creatures targeting them have advantage to hit. Keep in mind, this doesn't work on creatures that can't be charmed, and they reroll their save if they spend an action trying to do so. 12th level bards get an ability score improvement, give your dexterity some love for some better AC and better crossbow shots. 13th level bards get their Song of Rest bumped up to a d10. Honestly, this just doesn't scale well at all. Considering a d6 at level 2 could be half of someone's hit points, a d10 at this level is basically a band-aid. You can also learn 7th level spells. Regenerate heals 4d8 plus 15 on the first round, 1 HP after that round for an hour. They also grow back limbs in about 2 minutes, provided they haven't already thrown a robot arm on. 14th level bards can grab 2 more spells from any list. Mass Healing Word heals up to 6 creatures, 1d4 plus your charisma modifier. It's a 3rd level spell, and you get to add 1d4 per spell level, and it's also a bonus action. That's the real reason it's so good. Heal heals 70 HP of a single target, and also cures any diseases. You also get Fool's Luck from the College of Satire, meaning you can add an inspo die to a failed attack roll, ability check, or saving throw. If you succeed, the DM will hold on to that bonus and apply it to a check you make later to make you embarrass yourself. This subclass is kind of silly. 15th level bards upgrade their inspiration die to d12s. You can also learn 8th level spells. Glibness makes all of your charisma checks 15 before you apply your modifier for an hour. Considering your modifier is plus 5 minimum or plus 17 to performance, you can really bring out the charm. And not that you would lie, but if you did, no magic would be able to prevent that. 16th level bards get an ability score improvement. Our dexterity is pretty close to capping. Hopefully you rolled well and get it there. Otherwise, round off something else out. There's no point of getting a 19 instead of an 18. 17th level bards can learn 9th level spells. Foresight lets you give a creature you touch advantage on all d20 rolls, immunity to being surprised, and creatures attacking them have disadvantage on attack rolls against them. Song of Rest also increases to a d12. 18th level bards can learn 2 more spells from any list. Mass Heal from the Cleric list gives you 700 HP to distribute to creatures you can see within 60 feet. Also removes any disease, blinding, or deafening effects so you can really pump it up. Aura of Vitality is a 3rd level spell from the Paladin list. It creates a radius of 30 around you, then you can use a bonus action to heal creatures within that 2d6 hit points for up to a minute, depending on your concentration. 19th level bards get an ability score improvement. Round off anything odd here, dexterity and charisma get them capped if they're not already. Our capstone here will be 20th level of bard, giving you superior inspiration, which means that if you've used all 5 of your bardic inspiration, still get 1 whenever you roll initiative. Now that we've hit level 20, let's figure out how good of a build this is. First, you have a ton of healing options, many that work on an area of effect, keeping the whole party healthy. Second, you've got mobility to get in and out of the area you need to be to cast those spells. Finally, you're great at bolstering the party in general, with inspiration and spells like haste, not to mention crazy high charisma checks. As far as weaknesses go, a lot of your spells are concentration. Sure, you can swap between speed and healing at will in the game, but in D&D, swapping between Beacon of Hope and Haste is wasting spell slots. Concentration is also an issue with your low con score, meaning you only have plus 1 to save. Speaking of low constitution, your HP is around 120-ish if I'm being generous, so try not to die. But you're a healer, so just keep yourself healthy and keep the rest of the party healthy. If they appreciate your healing, they'll be staying in the front, letting you keep away from the damage, and fixing them up as long as they take hits for you. Just don't be afraid to disengage when you have to, frogs are fragile creatures. Thanks for watching. If you like the video, subscribe for more. We put out at least one build a week. If you're still into Overwatch and want to see more Overwatch characters get built, get this video to 30 likes. I'll put together another one. Come back next week. We got more builds, more fun.